Notorious B.I.G.'s debut album, Ready to Die, would earn him critical acclaim and commercial success with songs like Big Papa and Juicy. He would work with Sean P. Diddy Combs, mentor rappers like Lil Cease and Lil Kim, and posthumously collaborate with Eminem, Snoop Dogg, Method Man, Busta Rhymes, Bone Thugs and Harmony, and even his friend turned rival Tupac. He would go from slinging drugs on street corners just to get by to accumulating an estimated net worth of $160 million, but the money would fuel a host of new problems for the hip-hop legend.
The more money you make, the more problems you get.
He would be accused of being involved in Tupac's murder and would deny wishing death on him or anyone.
Now, even though we was going through our drama, I would never wish death on nobody, you know what I'm saying, because ain't no coming back from that.
After Biggie Smalls would meet the same fate just 6 months later in a murder that to this day remains officially unsolved, leaving behind his wife Faith Evans, his daughter Tiana, and his son Christopher Jr., who would eventually attempt to follow in his father's footsteps. XXL asked several rappers to name their 5 favorite MCs back in 2003. Notorious B.I.G.'s name came up more often than anyone else. Like Tupac, he's released more work posthumously than he did during his lifetime, with both Life After Death and Born Again going double platinum and peaking at number 1 on the US Billboard charts. There's been no shortage of controversy surrounding his murder, and he's been the subject of many documentaries, including the 2009 biopic Notorious, directed by George Tillman and starring Jamal Wooler. That video was about his life, and we're going to talk about how he changed the world. What's going on, guys? My name is Michael McCrud, documenting the legacy of Notorious B.I.G. after his tragic death, here for you on After They Were Gone. We recently covered the legacy of Tupac Shakur, so you might want to check out that video. Just don't do it back to back, they might get upset. As always, be sure to let us know in the comments down below who you want me to document next. Oh, and as always, well, feel free to leave your respects for Biggie and his family, you know where.
You brought up around that type of lifestyle where, you know, when you tote guns all your life and then you get a record deal, it's kind of hard to break that habit. You know what I'm saying?
Notorious B.I.G. was born Christopher George Latour Wallace on May 21st, 1972 in Brooklyn, New York. Growing up, Christopher was a promising student, winning awards for his talent in English, but took to hustling at a young age and began selling drugs when he was just 12 years old. At 17, he was arrested on weapons charges, the first of several leading up to 9 months in a North Carolina prison. After that, he decided to turn his life around and focus on making music. After performing on the streets, forming a rap collective called Old Gold Brothers, and recording demos in his mom's basement, Biggie was discovered by Sean Puffy Combs, and Puff Daddy would soon after start his own label, Bad Boy Entertainment. And what good is a label if you don't have a rising star? So that's when he decided to sign Biggie. Good move. There were high hopes for Biggie Smalls, who would later change his name to Notorious B.I.G., and he did not disappoint. His first studio album, Ready to Die, launched in 1994, sold 4 million copies, and achieved widespread critical acclaim. That album featured some of hip-hop's most iconic songs like Juicy and Big Pop. 90s Notorious B.I.G. was widely recognized as the king of East Coast hip-hop. As such, his beef with Tupac came to create a greater East Coast-West Coast feud.
One man against one man made a whole West Coast hate a whole East Coast, and vice versa.
After Tupac's death in 1996, Biggie felt a need to squash the constant feud, and even reached out to Snoop Dogg, telling him he never hated Tupac. In his final months, Notorious B.I.G. was hard at work promoting his upcoming album, Life After Death. In February of 1997, he dropped its first single, Hypnotize. It'd be the last Biggie track released within his lifetime, as he would be gunned down on March 9th of that year. That night, his SUV was stopped at a red light at the corner of Wilshire Boulevard and South Fairfax Avenue in Los Angeles. A dark-colored Impala pulled up alongside. The driver rolled down his window, drew a pistol, and shot Biggie 4 times.
He was hunched over, and I was just there, I was talking to him. I told him to just jump in his vehicle, let's just try to rush him to the hospital. And that's what we did.
He was rushed to Cedars-Sinai Medical Center, but was pronounced dead within 30 minutes. Like the murder of Tupac, Biggie's murder has never been officially solved. Although, according to LA Times, the key suspect was a member of the Crips who apparently carried out the murder for money. Biggie's funeral was held in Manhattan and attended by 350 mourners, among whom were Lil' Kim, Lil' Cease, Mary J. Blige, Queen Latifah, Run DMC, Busta Rhymes, Foxy Brown, and Flava Flav. Notorious B.I.G. was also commemorated by his longtime collaborator, Sean Combs, in the song, I'll Be Missing You. A week after his funeral, Bad Boy Records released Notorious B.I.G.'s album, Life After Death, featuring songs like Hypnotize and Mo' Money, Mo' Problems. The album was nominated for 3 Grammys and reached number 1 on the US Billboard charts. Biggie would hit number 1 again just 2 years later with Born Again, which featured early recorded verses and new beats and new guest rappers like Puff Daddy, Eminem, Snoop Dogg, Busta Rhymes, Ice Cube, and Method Man. A similar approach was taken for Biggie's last studio album, Duets, The Final Chapter, which featured some surprising collaborators like Korn, Bob Marley, and spoken word pieces from both his kids. Biggie Smalls' death had left a vacuum in the East Coast rap scene, with many artists itching to be crowned the King of New York. This would spark the famous beef between Jay-Z and Nas. The riff would last for a decade as the two exchanged insults in their lyrics. Jay hit Nas with tracks like The Takeover. Nas fired back with songs like Ether,
in which I think he won.
Finally ended when Nas signed to Jay-Z's Def Jam Records in 2006 and made a surprise appearance at Jay-Z's I Declare War concert. Apparently not war on one another. Biggie has been remembered in documentaries like Biggie and Tupac from 2002, Notorious B.I.G. Bigger Than Life in 2007, and his biopic Notorious in 2009. The film was produced by Sean Combs, Valletta Wallace, and Biggie's former manager Wayne Barrow and Mark Pitts. Rapper Jamal Woolard was chosen to play Biggie as an adult, while Biggie's son, Christopher Wallace, played him as a child. Bad Boy Records released the soundtrack featuring some of Biggie's greatest songs like Hypnotize, Juicy, and Warning, and the movie grossed $44 million worldwide.
You won't end up like those worthless bums you hang with, don't you see that?
One of you is going down for carrying an illegal firearm. You decide who.
Notorious B.I.G.'s lyrics have been sampled and referenced by a long list of artists, including Eminem, Jay-Z, 50 Cent, Nelly, Lil Wayne, The Game, and Usher. He has been the subject of street art all over the world, including a massive mural in Fulton Street in Brooklyn, just a half mile from the Star's old block. Biggie is also remembered with the Christopher Wallace Memorial Foundation, which holds a black tie dinner each and every year called B.I.G. Night Out to raise funds for children's school supplies. As for the rest of the story, well, we'll have to wait and see. I'd love to see this guy in a hologram. I guess they're just working on the technology to make bigger holograms, right? Anyway, for the rest of the story, well, I think that's it, because this is after they were gone. Thanks so much for watching this video, guys. We have two videos in front of you now. You can click on one of those. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel, well, I think it's about time. So hit it, right meow. See you guys in another video.